An entrepreneur needs to take care of his family and his business. It cannot be at the cost of one or the other.
As an entrepreneur, it is extremely important to build an organization.
We've always believed in not just working for shareholder interests, but working for stakeholder interests.
It involved being fair to your customer, to your supplier, to your employees, so that there is stability everywhere.
Everything that we do, we have a very long-term perspective on the business.
Entrepreneurship is about craziness.
I was trying to build a business on a technology that nobody understood.
People looked at me with disbelief and said, how can this guy even dream of turning around this company?
I have never hesitated during my entire career of 40 years to disagree with the promoters.
I actually always has been trying new things in my career, disrupt it as much as possible.
In real estate, if you ask us, it's a very simple business. It's like tap dancing on a minefield.
It gives a lot of pleasure to do something which improves the technology and also doesn't cost much.
High quality, low cost diagnostics should get into every district of India.
And we never turn out any patient for the sake of cost.
We were able to break through and make the next refrigerant gas.
In fact, we had our word processor launched before Google launched Google Docs.
The problem we are focused on is big enough. The middle class, death, disease, disability. We want to solve that.
I want to bet on beauty. Why can't it be a big business in India?
Once you aim high, you must come out of the comfort zone.
You get a failure, you have to be prepared for like 99 more failures.
But there was no way we were going to fail. I mean, failure was not an option.
If we believe in stuff which we do and enjoy things which we're doing, we'll always have success.
I strongly believe that by 2050, by purchasing power parity, India will be the largest economy in the world.